But first, exclusive new information just coming into the Situation Room. We're learning about two disturbing close encounters between Iranian Navy boats and U.S. warships in the Strait of Hormuz and in the Persian Gulf. This provocative behavior only fueling already heightened tensions between the United States and Iran. Let's get straight to our Pentagon correspondent, Barbara Starr. She's got the details. What do we know, Barbara?
Wolf, at a time of heightened tensions, the Pentagon still wants to say this is relatively routine, but listen to what happened last Friday in the Strait of Hormuz and the Persian Gulf to both a U.S. Navy warship and a U.S. Coast Guard cutter. The Navy warship first up, the USS New Orleans, was going into the Persian Gulf. It was going through the Strait of Hormuz when three Iranian speedboats approached it at high speed and came within 500 yards at high speed within range of this Navy warship. The Navy warship signaled the Iranians to back off. They ignored all signals. That is in opposition to standard maritime procedures. Eventually, we were told they did break away. Another incident the same day, a U.S. Coast Guard cutter called the ADAC was up in the Persian Gulf. It was just about 75 miles east of Kuwait when it was harassed by high-speed Iranian boats, small boats that came at it also at high speed. The personnel on board the Coast Guard cutter said that they observed Iranians with AK-47s, and they believe one of the machine guns at the front of one of those Iranian speedboats was pointed right at them. Eventually, a larger Iranian naval vessel intervened, and those small speedboats backed off. Routine or not, these types of encounters are extremely concerning to the U.S. Navy. You know, the question really is, Wolf, how close do you let an Iranian speedboat get to you before you have to do something about it? Wolf?
Yeah, I'm sure. That-